Hello friends, welcome to CAD Tutorials for Beginners. In this tutorial we will learn the new sketch based feature, that is multi-section solid. So basically the multi-section solid command is useful for the addition of material between two same or different cross sections along with the spine or the guides with or without the guide path. So let's click on the multi-section solid definition. The dialog box open up. So here we have to provide the sections profiles. Those can be more than two. Below that we can provide the guide spines along which the material is getting added. Then we have to select the coupling points. So there are four coupling types here: ratio, tangency, then curvature and vertices. We will see all these four options with the help of example. Then we have the delimitation, and below that we can provide for the provide these parameters for the smoothing. So now let us understand this command with the help of examples. So first example we will see with the same cross sections of rectangular section, and that will be without guide path. So I will select the sketch positioning and I will draw on the top plane. So here create the rectangular profile and we will provide the dimensions. Let's provide 150 mm and this one will provide 100 mm. And now exit the workbench. So now this is one profile we have created. Now we will create one more profile. Let's select the plane definition and we will create one offset plane from the top plane by 150 mm. And here again we'll draw one rectangular profile. So just click on the fit all option and here just create another rectangle. Exit the workbench and now we will use the multi-section solid. So click on the multi-section solid, select the sketch one, select this sketch two. Now you can see there is one closing point one and closing point two. So keep in mind that for both the profile this closing point must be properly aligned and must be in the same quadrant. Also the direction of the material addition must be the same. So now once we select the profiles, we have to select the coupling mode. So here we will select the vertices option and click on the preview. So now you can see with the four vertices for both the profiles we have four vertices as well as the four segments. So now we will select the vertices option and click on OK. So now here for this type of multi-section solid we don't have to provide the coupling points. It is automatically selecting the proper vertices because both the profiles have same vertices. So now I will just delete this one, just delete this multi-section solid, and on this sketch 2 now instead of rectangular section now we will create a circular section. Just create a circular section over here and exit the workbench. So now if we use the multi-section solid, just select the section 2, section 1 and section 2. Now we can see that there are four segments and four vertices for this rectangular section, and for the circular there is no vertices but you have the two segments. So by default it is selecting the closing point 1 and closing point 2. So now if you try to preview it, it will show the error message and it will give a tip that change the coupling mode to the ratio. So now again go to the coupling mode. And if we select the ratio, it will preview it, but it will create an twist over here. So the coupling mode ratio creates a multi-section solid no matter the cross section is, as well as the number of vertices. So whenever there is a different cross section and any number of vertices, ratio create a multi-section solid. But if you click on OK, now as we know that we have the four vertices, but on the circle it is creating more than four vertices, which are the unnecessary vertices. So to avoid this, to create this multi-section solid in a better way, we can use the another option, that is tangencies and curvature and the vertices. But again, for the tangency then curvature option, profile can be anything, but there must be same number of vertex points on both of the profiles. So we need to create those first. So just delete this one and we will create the points over here. Just click on this one and we'll create the four points. We'll create approximate and we'll create one more point and just exit the workbench. Now again click on the multi-section solid and select this cross section, select this cross section, and here we have to provide the coupling points. So again we will just change this closing point to this point, so that both the points will align properly, and we can add the coupling points over here. Now we can use those points which we have created. So go to the coupling mode and select this option, that is tangency then curvature, and here we will create the couplings. So again, make sure that if you select this cage as a first cage in this section, then you must select the first coupling point from this first sketch only. So if you directly select from this one, it will show the error. So click on OK and just remove this coupling point, coupling mode here, just remove all. And now we will create the couplings. For select the first point and select the second point, so the first coupling is added. Then one by one you can add the different couplings over here. Select the first point, then second point, select this one and this one. So actually there is no need to select this closing point coupling over here. It will create a multi-section solid. So now you can see, first we have selected the two sketches, then we have selected a coupling mode as tangency then curvature, and then we have created these four couplings, coupling 1, 2, 3, and 4, and now we can preview it. So you can see the same multi-section solid is created with the help of tangency then curvature option. Now we have the third coupling mode, that is vertices. So again we will see how this multi-section solid can be created with the help of the third option, that is vertices. So for that option, to use the vertices option, the cross-section can be anything, but again the number of vertices must be the same. But if you see with these points, these are not the vertices. For rectangle by default there are four vertices. So if you try to divide this circle into four sections, it will create a four vertices. So now we'll just delete this first. Just delete this multi-section and now again go to the sketch. So just delete these points, so use the point filter and select the points and delete those. Now we will create a line at an angle. Let's create a line. Just disable this one and select this, create angle of 45 degree, and we will just rotate it. We'll make a pattern of this circle, this axis. Select the center point and here we will add the angle as 90 degree. So now you can see the circle is divided into four parts, and now we will break this into the different pieces. Just check this break and keep and select one by one. Just double click on it, and so that it will keep executing. Select the second, select the third. So now if you try to go over it, you can see there are four different sections created, and now exit the workbench. So now if you come into the 3D, you can see there are four vertices created, and this is the requirement to use the vertices in multi-section. So just click on the multi-section, select the first sketch, select the second sketch, and now you can choose the option that is vertices. So again, if you preview it, you can see there is a twist happening here, and to avoid this one, we will just replace this closing point here and just preview it. So you can see the multi-section solid is created by using the coupling mode of vertices. So in this way, we can use the coupling modes for ratio, for tangency, tangency then curvature, and the vertices option. So now again, I will just delete this one. And now instead of these two separate options, we'll just change this sketch to again circle. So we'll use both the circular profiles and exit the workbench. So now again, use the multi-section solid, select the first sketch, select the second sketch, and preview after it. You can see the twist is there. Select the tangency, and now we'll just change this coupling mode to the other side. So just change this closing point, replace it with this, and now preview it. You can see the correct multi-section solid is created, and again click on OK. So in this way, you can create the multi-section solid in CATIA V5. So now we have seen the examples so far are without guide path. So now we will create the guide path. Just delete this multi-section solid, and now we will create one guide path over here. Let's draw on the front plane, and here we will use the spline command. And here we will just project this circular sections so that we will get the end point. Again, select the projection and now exit the workbench. So not exit actually. So we'll just make this two as a construction element. And now we'll provide the construction to these end points. Again, select the constraints, and make them coincidence. So I will just change this little bit. And I will create one more spline over here. Let's create one more spline. Sorry, that must be in the another sketch. So let's understand this first guide first. Now select the multi-section, select this first sketch, select this second sketch, and Now click on the preview. So again we have to change this coupling point. Again click on preview. Now you can see the correct multi-section solid is created, and now we'll provide the guide. In this guides, just select this option and select this guide curve. Now you can see the material is adding along this guide path. So one more tab is there for the relimitation. So basically relimitation applies when we have the guide path which is for which the length is more than or greater than the distance between these two profiles. So if the guide path is crossing these two profiles, then we can relimit on the start section or the end section, so that the multi-section solid is created only between those two profiles. So it means that the guide path can be extended one, can be the longer one than this distance between these two profiles. We just cancel this one. So now again, let's create one more guide over here. We'll see how the shape will change for the multi-section. So again, we'll just project this circular edge and again select the both the edges and make them construction. Again make this off and just click on the normal view. Here again I will take the spline for the reference and escape this one. So again with the constraints we can provide the coincidence constraint over here. Similarly, I will provide one more constraint. Make sure that both the profiles have intersecting or the guide should be connected with this both the profiles. So exit the workbench. So now again use the multi-section solid, select the sketch 1, select the sketch 2, and now in the guide we have to select these two guides. So that's why it must be in the two different sketches. So again preview after it. So here again we have to change the closing point. Just replace this with this point and preview after it. So in this way the multi-section solid is created with two guides. Just double click on it. So here there are some options available for the smoothing parameters. So first is the angular correction and second is the deviation. So angular correction is basically smoothes the lofting motion along the reference curves, reference guide curves. This may be necessary when the small discontinuities are detected with regard to the spine tangency or reference guide curves normal. The smoothing is done for any discontinuity which angular deviation is smaller than or the degree, and therefore helps generating better quality for the resulting multi-section solid. So we'll just select this angular correction over here. So if there are any discontinuities, that can be removed with this angular corrections option. Similarly, if we apply the deviation, so the deviation smooths the lofting motion by deviating from the guide curve. So if you have this guide curve, it can allow deviate by this much of dimensions. So just click on preview. So it will add the smoothing parameters. So now again, let's delete this one. Delete all the children's, and here again we'll just delete this. Now again I will just double click on this to edit this sketch, and here instead of two sketches, we will use the three sketches now. So here we'll create a rectangle. Just create a rectangle of approximate size. Exit after it and create one more plane from this top plane. And now we'll provide this approximate distance. Again, draw on this plane. Just click on the feet option. And here we will provide the hexagon. Sorry, here we'll provide the hexagon. So provide the side here, and again I will just make this as horizontal. Click on this one and we'll add here 150 mm, and then exit the workbench. So now we have to create the multi-section over here. Just hide this plane and we'll hide this one as well. So again, as we have already seen the all the cases regarding the multi-section solid coupling modes. So here we'll use the tangency then curvature. So for this, definitely we must have all the profiles with different with same number of vertices. So for hexagon we have all six vertices. For rectangle we must have six, but we have only four vertices. So here we will create the vertices, or we can just simply create the points. So just click on this edge and here we'll create in between and just add 0.5. so 0.1 and 0.2, and just create it. So one point is created. Similarly, we'll create another point. Select this line and again we will select the between option and we'll create the ratio. Select the first point and select the second point. Just click. So I think this is something wrong. Just go to the definition. Select this point and select this point, and this is now correctly created. Okay, so now we have these six vertices over here, or we can say six divisions we have here. So these are basically only the coupling points if we use the tangency then curvature option. Similarly, we will create the points over here in the sketch itself. Just go into the sketch and here we can use the option that is equidistance point. Just click on it and create the six points. Just click on OK and exit the workbench. Now select the multi-section solid and now select the first point. So first we have to select the sections, section 1, section 2 and section 3. Now in the coupling modes, keep this tangency and curvature, and if you directly select the ratio option, if you preview it, you can see there is lots of twist happening here. And now we will just change this point to this one. Preview after it, it is little bit solved. And now we'll use the next option, that is tangency curvature. So currently it is showing the error because there is no coupling points are selected. So we can just cancel it and we'll select the fresh, select the first sketch, select the second sketch, select the third sketch, and in the coupling mode now we will select the coupling points. So select the first point, select this edge here and select then this edge. Similarly, I will create another coupling point here select this point and then select this point. Then select the third one, this one, and then this one. Similarly for these points, this one, this point, and then this point, and then this point, and the last one, this point and this point. Just click on preview. So here again select the correct closing point, select the point over here and keep this as it is. Again select this point and replace with this point, and then now preview after it. So again it is showing the error, so that it is creating the cusp. Select this point and replace with this one, and now preview after it. So now it is correctly created. It was selected wrongly. You can see the proper multi-section solid is created with the help of coupling point, coupling mode, that is tangency then curvature. Just click on OK. So now again, if you want to create the multi-section solid with a coupling mode, that is vertices, then again you need to divide this circular portion in two, as well as this rectangular, you have to divide into the two sections, then it will create the multi-section solid with this vertices. So thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe our YouTube channel for such more CAD videos. Also click on the bell icon to get the notifications for the updates. Thank you so much.